G'day guys, back again, hope you're doing well. Now, I've seen a couple of painting videos on YouTube for figure painting, and what I wanted to do really was just do one of my own from my experience earlier on painting. Just do a very simple video on what I think if you're just starting out in figures, and I mean just starting out, is a pretty simple way of just getting something a little bit decent, but I think it's an easy technique. Yeah, I'm not going to paint a whole figure. I'm just going to show you this basic technique. Now, I've decided to pick some cheap figure because obviously if you're just starting out, I recommend getting some of the Tamiya cheap figures, just trying them out. This one here, I've actually got another set of these I picked up for $8. This one was $11, so that's actually a little bit more expensive. You can find these pretty cheap. That's Australian, obviously. And I thought just for the example, I'll just paint this guy here, or part of him anyway. I don't know if I'll do the face. I just wanted to do a bit of the uniform. Because again, I just wanted to keep this simple, and if I get any response to the video, I'll do another one. So here we go. So for this, guys, all I'm going to use is three colors, and I couldn't find my standard, I think, what is it, black from Vallejo, so I'm just going to use a German gray, and we're just going to use the, you can use all types of whites. This is just an example. We'll start off, to make it easy, we'll just get a proper German field gray for our base sort of color, and then for our lowlights we'll use this, and our highlights we'll use that. So basically just three colors. I used to use Tamiya paints when I first started painting, because to some degree it was almost the only game in town, apart from other enamels like Hombrel and stuff like that. My advice is, if you're just starting out painting, don't use these, because you'll just improve a lot more if you're using something like Vallejo or whatever else is out there, AK. There's lots of brands out there, but this is sort of a brand that's easy for us to get here in Australia. I'm going to use a wet palette for this. I've done a video on this, so if you want to check how to do that, a wet palette, have a look at my video or something else, another one online. All I can say, guys, is I know this looks a little bit advanced, you know, the wet palette thing, but it will help you to know, and it isn't actually advanced. It actually makes things a hell of a lot easier, and your paint and your figures will look a lot better straight away. I used to use one of these before a wet palette, and you know, these things like this dry out in one of these containers very quickly. I mean, you can use a retarder and stuff like that, but I find just having it in here, it works a lot easier than having it in one of these. Now, obviously, I need to put some paper over the top of this. Just watch my video if you haven't seen it, and we'll get started. Now, guys, you're probably just starting off, and as I said, if you're a beginner and you don't want to do any of this stuff at the start, you don't need to. Just cut the figure off the sprue and get started, but I'll just show you a couple of things which don't take long to do, and it will make your figure look a lot better than not doing it. So as you can see with a lot of these Tamiya figures, you'll probably see it, you get quite a nasty seam line down these old Tamiya figures, and you actually notice them sometimes a lot more once you start painting them. So I don't know if it'll show up, but on this side you can see I've got rid of that line that comes down the figure, whereas on this side, hopefully you see it'll come up, it's still quite prominent. Now, there's lots of ways of doing this. Probably when I was just starting out, and the easiest way of doing this is just really running a blade, if you like, down the figure. Now, I prefer just to cut it or slice it like so, just taking it off the figure. And again, with this, even as you're going along, if you wanted to, if you notice that some of the creases aren't as nice as what you'd like, you can even just gouge your knife into that area a little bit more, just to get rid of the seam line. And a lot of times when I'm a bit lazy, I'll just sort of scrape it down like this. And that sort of gets rid of most of the line. And around the boots, you can sort of just cut it in a little bit more, because the seam line sort of sticks out, just to make the boot line. It helps get rid of that seam. Seam line does go in the inside as well. You can probably see it a lot more there, that seam line. And obviously, and again, guys, this is really up to you. You can go in later with a bit of a file and just give it a little bit of a sand. I don't know why I said file, but a bit of a sand, and you can sort of get rid of that a little bit better. And then you can even go in with another little sanding stick and clean it up a little bit more. But like I said, if you're just starting out, you don't want to do that. Just clip the figure off and get started. I just wanted to show you that probably the biggest thing when you get a little bit more advanced in modeling is the amount of time you spend on cleaning up a figure or a tank or a resin kit and prepping it, the better it's going to look in the end. So sometimes, even though it's painful, getting some of these early techniques down first of just getting rid of those little lines and cleaning it up really does pay dividends in the future when you're wanting to display a figure or go in a competition or something like that, because they're the sort of things that later on you'll probably get penalized for. But if you just want to build 30 of these figures and put them in a diorama and you just want them to look decently painted, well then, you know, you don't have to worry about this sort of stuff. Next thing I'll do is prime the figure. And for me, guys, I just like the Tamiya primer in the can. I use it for pretty much everything. Even just my armor kits. I just absolutely love this stuff. So, and it's a lot quicker than using an airbrush. And I just try and find a suitable base to put the figure on. So you, obviously when you're holding it, you can paint it. Sometimes I just use the old spray can lid or something like that. Just got to make sure. Some people use, obviously, they'll drill a hole in the end and put pins in and put it in a cork, but that's getting a bit too advanced for us guys, so let's just keep it simple. Sometimes I even put just a piece of blue tack on there and I'll sit on the blue tack or just glue it onto something that's stable. Just make sure that if you're gluing it onto something that it's you can get it off easily enough without breaking the ankles off and that it will stick. So I've got my trusty wet pallet now. First thing that I like to do is just to almost just block out some of the stuff. So I couldn't find my my black, so we'll go with German grey anyway. Give it a good shake. And I'll just throw that just in the corner there. The first thing I like to do is pretty much just go and block out some of the, probably just some of the shaded areas. And the reason why I use a wet palette is I used to use something like this, just your normal tray. And this thing just dries out your paints far too fast, guys. So do yourself a favor and get yourself just a wet palette of any description. I've done a video of mine, so you can have a look at it. Very cheap, just a thing of chocolate, box from Chocolates, and just a sponge and some baking paper. And it'll just save you a lot of paint. And it also keeps your paint wet for maybe 3 days or a week, depending on how much you moisten it, compared to having it in the tray here, which will dry up in my climate in about 5 or 10 minutes. And again with this, because you're blocking it out, you can just go over your actual straps that you're going to paint anyway, and then just go on the side of those as well, and that can just help you outline the figure to start off with anyway, and it gives you just a rough idea. It just starts helping you block out and start making you feel like you're actually getting somewhere. Everyone's got their own painting styles, but I find just for a beginner, I think some of those sort of advanced painting techniques can sort of really put you off painting to some degree, or it can make you feel like it's miles away from achieving something. So this is really just my video of a bit of a quick example of how you can paint just with a couple of colors. And I'm just going over the creases here now just for the low lights. And as I said, you can paint the straps. I mean, I technically, you know, this is a gray, but this is just a tutorial, guys. I'm not going to go into the actual 100% right colors. I'm just showing you more about technique, or my sort of early on stages technique that I should have done early on, but I was using these old Tamiya paints, which were terrible. So I much prefer the Vallejo or the Joe Sonia's now. The paintbrushes, I mean, obviously, you don't need to spend a fortune on paintbrushes when you're first starting, but probably just the sizes of the paintbrushes is the main thing. If you're wanting to get a bit of a fine line, and obviously, you know, you can't do that with a big, massive brush. Well, you can, actually, if you use the corner of it. But, you know, they're sort of techniques that you can learn. But, you know, just try and look at a couple of brushes and what size figure you're painting, and just sort of get a bit of a rough idea what you think it's going to take you to draw or paint a nice thin line. And obviously the thinner your paint is, you know, if it's big and globby, it's going to be harder for you to paint a thin line. So guys, you get the gist of what I'm doing here. So I'm just going to go around and sort of outline most of the detail, and then we'll come back. And all I've done is pretty much just blocked out pretty much everything that I can sort of, or mostly, all the, just the outlining of the pockets. I've painted the boots, just around the ammo and the straps. Just really blocked out everything with that. And I've sort of filled in, and I've also run through some of the creases. And I've also done some sort of imaginary creases, if you like. And some shadowing, if you can see, down in the middle of the legs there. And around the back, you can sort of see I've sort of just imagined where some creases might be. And I've just used the black to go across those. Again, up here, you can sort of see where I've made some stuff up. And just sort of, you know, blocked out the straps at the back. Around the collar there. Just anywhere really where you think there might be a bit of a shadow. And I wasn't going to do the face, but because I had this out, and I don't normally do it this way, but I thought I'd give it a shot. And I've just sort of blacked out some of the creases in where I think some of the shadows might be in the face, and are under the jawline there, just for the sake of it. May turn out terribly, and I wasn't even going to paint the face. I was really just going to do this part of the figure, the uniform. So that's pretty much it, guys. So one paint color so far, other than the primer. And I've just basically blocked out around the pockets and everything like that. So that's pretty much where I'm at the moment. Next step, I think we'll go with just the German field gray, again from Vallejo. And we'll just start doing some light coats over the top of this and sort of around the straps and everything, and try and get something that starts looking a little bit like a painted figure for a beginner.